ketones are a great fuel source for the brain.
We can make ketones endogenously, meaning we can make them in our body, and then we can provide them exogenously, which means we're giving ketones. That's why we say Pruvit gives exogenous ketones. Well, caffeine actually stimulates your body to make endogenous ketones. So when you have them both combined, then basically you're promoting fat burning and production of ketones in your body, and you're giving exogenous ketones. So you're getting kind of a combination of two with the caffeine. So we call caffeine is what we call a ketogenic type of supplement. It makes your body produce ketones by itself.
We can think of the major energy sources for our body as coming from fats and carbohydrates. And so carbohydrates will get broken down through metabolic pathways into a molecule called glucose, sometimes referred to as blood sugar. And fats will get converted or broken down into fatty acids, which are just the little building blocks of larger fats that we eat, or in particular circumstances, these molecules called ketones.
It's going to be very hard to get in ketosis if you're not following a ketogenic diet. One of the reasons why we try and promote the lifestyle is because we're trying to also promote endogenous production of ketones along with exogenous, or at least put your body in a state where you can kind of produce some ketones too. So if you're on a high carb diet, it's probably not going to. Caffeine by itself.
So caffeine can be great, right? But caffeine often is a quick spurt and then you kind of get a downer. Ketones are an energy source. They actually provide energy for the brain, whereas caffeine is very short-lived. It does not provide energy. It just provides this feeling of energy. Ketones actually provide energy.
As we age, our brains don't process glucose as efficiently. So even if you have enough glucose in the brain, your brain is not able to utilize the glucose that's available to it effectively. So it has low energy, put simply. And the ketones, if it has access to ketones, it'll process those first.
When you don't have enough calories and your body needs energy, it'll go and break down the fat from our body stores and release it so that the body can use that. But the brain is special, it's protected. It's not as easy to get to. And the brain cannot efficiently use these fatty acid molecules for energy. Fatty acids are broken down into ketones, which are water soluble, and they're able to cross something called the blood-brain barrier, which means that they can get into the brain and be a fuel for the neurons and the supporting cells in our brain. So about 20% of the energy that we use on a daily basis goes to fuel our brain, even though our brain is only about 2% of our body weight. We, for a long time, kind of had this conversation, especially in the academic community, that glucose was really the only energy for the brain. It's the only thing that the brain can use. And it's just not true. We know, and we have known for a long time, that ketones are very efficient energy substrates for the brain,
which increases focus and energy without the downer.